Blessed Gregory, raised from the throne of Peter, sought always the beauty of the Lord and lived in celebration of that love.
Dear brothers and sisters, I would like to offer this Mass for my beloved mother, Germaine Bawomba. Today is the birthday of her death. So may her soul and the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Dear brothers and sisters, today we also celebrate Saint Gregory the Great, Pope and Doctor of the Church. May He intercede for us, intercede for the church in our journey toward holiness. And in order for us to be worthy of offering this Holy Eucharist to God our Father, let us call to mind our sins, open our hearts to God's mercy. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts, in my words, in what I have done, and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. O God, who care for your people with gentleness and rule them in love, through the intercession of Pope Saint Gregory, endow, we pray, with a spirit of wisdom, those to whom you have given authority to govern, that the flourishing of a holy flock may become the eternal joy of the shepherds. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Colossians. Brothers and sisters, Christ Jesus is the image of the invisible God, the firstborn of all creation. For in him were created all things in heaven and on earth, the visible and the invisible, whether thrones or dominions or principalities or powers. All things were created through him and for him. He is before all things, and in him all things hold together. He is the head of the body, the church. He is the beginning, the firstborn from the dead, that in all things he himself might be preeminent. For in him all the fullness was pleased to dwell, and through him to reconcile all things for him, making peace by the blood of his cross through him, whether those on earth or those in heaven. The word of the Lord. Come with joy into the presence of the Lord. Sing joyfully to the Lord, all you lands. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come before him with joyful song. Come with joy. Know that the Lord is God. He made us, his we are, his people, the flock he tends. Come with joy. Enter his gates with thanksgiving, his courts with praise. Give thanks to him, bless his name. Come with joy. For he is good, the Lord whose kindness endures forever, and his faithfulness to all generations. Come with joy.
Of the world, says the Lord, whoever follows me will have the light of life. Alleluia, 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 alleluia. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. The scribes and the Pharisees said to Jesus, "The disciples of John the Baptist fast often and offer prayers, and the disciples of the Pharisees do the same. But yours eat and drink." Jesus answered them, "Can you make the wedding guests fast while the bridegroom is with them? But the days will come, and when the bridegroom is taken away from them, then they will fast in those days." And he also told them a parable. No one tears a piece from a new cloak to patch off an old one. Otherwise, he will tear the new, and the piece from it will not match the old cloak. Likewise, no one pours new wine into old wineskins. Otherwise, the new wine will burst the skins, and it will be spilled, and the skins will be ruined. Rather, new wine must be poured into fresh wine skins. And no one who has been drinking old wine desires new, for he says, the old is good. The Gospel of the Lord. Dear brothers and sisters, the Pharisees and the scribes are criticizing Jesus because his disciples do not follow the tradition of the elders. In their relationship with God, they are doing new things. They don't fast. They don't even wash their hands. They don't pray like the disciples of the Pharisees. So they are complaining that Jesus is bringing a new tradition. Indeed, as we heard in the first reading, all things came to be through Jesus. And he came in this world to help us to live our lives with a new way. Jesus came not to abolish the tradition, the Old Testament, but to fulfill it by giving it its real meaning. How we can serve God, our Father. So the teaching of Jesus could not go together with the legalistic way of Pharisees. It could not go together. When the Pharisees are so tough with their laws, but Jesus came to teach us how merciful our God is. The teaching of Jesus is based on mercy. The teaching of Jesus is not there to exclude sinners, but to welcome them. That's why he's giving that parable. We cannot put the new wine in the old wine skins, because the teaching of Jesus is a new wine based on mercy. God sent him to welcome all of us as sinners, but to reconcile us with God, our Father. He didn't come to exclude us, but to bring us together as the children of God, our Father. That is why we are here, dear brothers and sisters. Sinners, but God, our Lord Jesus Christ, brought us together to serve God, our Father. This is so amazing, dear brothers and sisters. But today also, if we see in our own lives, there are many things that cannot go together with the teaching of our Lord Jesus Christ. Like in the past, the legalistic spirit of the Pharisees could not go together with the teaching of Jesus. In our lives also, dear brothers and sisters, in our families, in our society, many things, many teachings today are opposite to the teaching of our Lord Jesus Christ. So, how are we living our lives today in order to follow the teaching of our Lord Jesus Christ? That is the question we can ask today. Jesus is inviting us, dear brothers and sisters, to be
uncompromising about our faith and the way that the Holy Spirit is working in our lives. That is the only way we can be his true disciples, following his teaching. So let us pray in this Eucharist. May the Holy Spirit, he is the only one who can help us to follow the teaching of our Lord Jesus Christ in our lives. The Holy Spirit is the only one who can help us to be those true disciples that Jesus needs, that our church needs, that our society needs. Those who can stand for peace, those who can stand for justice, those who can stand for respect of life, born and unborn.
Dear brothers and sisters, let's now present our petition to God, our Father, for ourselves, for the church, and the entire world.
For our Holy Father, our bishops and priests, that they may always point to Christ Jesus in their preaching, as the image of the invisible God and the one in whom all things hold together. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For world leaders, that Jesus, master of thrones, dominions, principalities, and powers, may be master of their thoughts and decisions. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the faithful, that we may be fresh wineskins into which the joy and grace of the Savior may be safely poured. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are in a season of suffering, bereavement, or emotional turmoil, that Jesus, in whom all things hold together, may make peace for them through the blood of the holy sacrifice. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our dear ones who have died, that the Lord may make them enter his gates with thanksgiving and his heavenly courts with praise. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. And for my beloved mother, Germaine Bawomba, for whom this Mass is being offered, may she find peace in God's kingdom. We pray to the Lord. And for all the victims of natural disaster, the victim of Ida, may the Holy Spirit be with them. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, our Father, hear the petition we present to you in the name of Jesus, your Son, our Lord. And may his mother, our Mother Mary, intercede for us sinners, as we pray. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and the work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Pray, brothers and sisters, may my sacrifice and yours be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good of all his
hosts. Grant our supplication, we pray, O Lord, that this sacrifice we present in celebration of Saint Gregory may be for our good, since through its offering you have loosed the offenses of all the world, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For in the marvelous confession of your saints, you make your church fruitful with strength ever new, and offer us sure signs of your love, and that your saving mysteries may be fulfilled, the great example lends us courage, the fervent prayers sustain us in all we do. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks, as in exaltation we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created righteously gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy this gift we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May you make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Martha, Saint Gregory, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant, Francis our Pope, and Sean our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servant, Germaine Bahomba, my mother, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she, who was united with your Son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have died and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters too, and to all who were pleasing to you as they're passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages, and praise you without end. Through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestowed on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. Dear brothers and sisters, the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us exchange the sign of peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say a word and my soul shall be healed.
This is the steward, faithful and prudent, whom the Lord set over his household to give them the allowance of food at the proper time.
Amen.
On behalf of those joining us by video, we say the prayer for spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Let us pray. Through Christ the teacher, O Lord, instruct those you feed with Christ the living bread, that on the feast day of Saint Gregory they may learn your truth and express it in works of charity. Through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Our mass is ended. Go in peace, glorifying God by your life. Have a wonderful day. Thank you. Immaculate Mary, your praises we sing. You reign now in heaven with Jesus again. Ave, Ave, Ave Maria, Ave.
Bless the Lord.